Welcome back, and once again, Taz and I are joined at the announce table by Brad Armstrong of the famous Armstrong Wrestling family, and Brad will lend us his expertise.
Well, thank you very much for having me. It's a pleasure. I missed you guys.
Oh, yeah, we missed you too. Kind of like a bed rash. You know what I mean? It's just a joke, but a happy new year, Brad.
Ha-ha.
Nice. Whoa.
This contest is set for one fall. Approaching the ring, weighing 270 pounds, Kevin Thorne.
Kevin Thorne and Ariel, the followers of vampirism, who, what a couple of freaks.
Oh, yeah, they kind of got that, like, bloodthirst, erotical, sexual thing going on. Can you relate to that, Brad? That's
Yeah, we can relate to that. This is a match Thorne can really sink his teeth into, I'm sure.
Ooh, wow, that was nice.
Thank you very little.
That was very good, and watch that little stuff, I heard that. Oh, look at that snap. See, I love the upside down back kick.
I used to use that move when I wrestled.
Did you really?
Yeah, I used a lot of moves, Taz.
Did they have ropes back then when you wrestled?
Yeah, they did, Taz.
I thought you guys wrestled on sand. Whoa, hey, heads up. Whoa, I thought he was going
to. Ariel's the kind of girl you want to bring home to your mother. Your mother's a mortician.
Yeah, when she's sleeping.
I thought that was camera trickery. Is that her real body?
No, that's her real body, bro. I mean, she's, heads up. Kind of like a, last time you were out, he was throwing a balls match. You much love balls. You really like balls a lot.
He's a nice guy.
And his opponent, from Nutley, New Jersey, weighing 310 pounds, Balls Mahoney.
Balls Mahoney, always balls to the wall, and quite frankly, a Neanderthal.
It means he's a caveman, Brad.
Yeah, I picked that up there, Taz. You know what?
What are you
sitting on a phone book over there, Taz?
You
need a spot over there, kid? You all right?
Listen, you got me by an inch.
Hey, stand up when you talk to me.
Easy,
I'm sorry.
Show you are standing up. You're a 5'9". Relax.
Hey, kid, you know what? These guys are great athletes in the ring, but I'll tell you, I was winning championships when they were in grade school. Okay, Taz?
Really?
Yeah,
right,
this
which
is
ones?
True.
Which ones? Tell us. You had a plethora of titles. Which ones?
Yeah, it was a world junior heavyweight title, but right now we got a match in the ring. Okay.
So mean when you were a little kid, you were a champion? You said junior.
Taz, hold it down over there, kid. Right, I'm trying to call him out.
All right, cool. Let's see you call.
This kid Thorne's got a lot of fire.
He's also a freak. Kevin Thorne is a fanged freak. But the fact is, he still goes about 265, 270 hard-hitting pounds, and Balls Mahoney just found that out.
Now, Balls Mahoney got his clock cleaned.
He's taking out the aggression on Balls right now. Buddy.
And the clean clock would be the only thing clean on Balls Mahoney. It was a little less than hygienic.
Kind of rearranging the facial features, which could be a good thing, and there's Ariel.
Such great things.
Yeah, I mean, if you rearrange Balls' face, that could only be a good thing.
And of course, we saw Kevin. Wait a minute.
Wow, back of the head.
Nasty. Kevin Thorne all over Balls Mahoney. You can hear Ariel screaming.
Well, it's kind of like Ariel gets like this. Oh, watch out now. Right in the ropes. It's like Ariel gets like this pleasure out of this or something.
She is deriving quite a bit of pleasure out of this. And from this position, I'm deriving quite a bit of pleasure out of her.
What position?
I'm sorry, from this table.
Exactly. Well, now Balls Mahoney's in trouble here for sure. Kevin Thorne, you got to be careful to get disqualified here.
That's a good-looking referee. He looks a lot like me.
Yeah, but by coincidence, Scott Armstrong, the brother of Brad, refereeing this matchup.
Yeah, how many brothers you got? Like 200, 300? How many you got?
Yeah, I got enough brothers to have our own Royal Rumble, okay?
And by the way,
who gets the looks in your family anyway?
Yeah, that would obviously be me.
Really?
Dad, did you just say 300? I thought I caught you saying tree.
I say tree?
Yeah, 1, 2, 3.
I did say tree. Yeah. Watch out. Move. I gotta stop that.
That lovely northern accent.
Yeah, you know, you can't beat it. Love that.
Our fans chant out Balls in unison. It's the big uppercut connected, and Kevin Thorne just fires right back.
You know, speaking of family members, Taz, I think I saw your family member the other day.
Really?
Hold on, covered. Two in.
That would be Willy Wonka and the Chocolate Factory.
It's over.
Ooh, really?
Yeah. You're an Oompa Loompa, Taz.
1970 wants that cartoon back. Anyway, well, Thorne was victorious.
Just like that, it's over.
No,
Kevin Thorne.
Kevin Thorne
drives the elbow right into the face, right into the mouth.
I'm telling you right now, there's no doubt. Guys, let's take a look at his impact here. And look at this. It's kind of like, look, Kevin Thorne hanging up Ariel upside down. Look at the impact right here. Watch this.
Wow.
Josh, you pointed out Brad Nasty right there.
Point of the elbow right in the mouth. I'm set. Looks like his mouth has been busted. He's bleeding from the mouth right now.
Well, that might just be his mouth. Oh, heads up. Hey, watch out now. Yeah, I think you're right. I think Bosmoney is busted open. One of his teeth is bleeding there or something. He might have broke his jaw. Who knows?
Wow.
That was
they
nasty.
Wanted.
Let's take another look at this. Check this out. Right under the jaw.
That might have broken. Yeah, that might have broken his jaw.
Well, you know what they say.
The vampire's out for blood, brother, and he got it.
Right on the button. Right on the button. You know what I'm saying? That's nasty. Look at this. All right, Brad, well, we'll see you later. Best of luck in your future endeavors.
Yeah, thanks a lot, Oompa Loompa.
I hear you. See you, country.
Balls my honey's in a bad way, guys.
Hey, I'll be back, Josh.
Bobby, how will you defend the ECW?